Hello, my besties, and welcome to another reaction. Today, I've got a song for you by my main man, Paul McCartney. The song is called Tug of War. It was requested for by Stephen Quartrell. Let's go get this.
It's a tug of war. What with one thing and another, it's a tug of war. We expected more, but with one thing and another, we were trying to outdo each other in a tug of war. In another world, in another world, we could stand on top of the mountain with our flag unfurled. In a time to come, in a time to come, we will be dancing to the beat played on a different drum. It's a tug of war, though I know I mustn't crumble, it's a tug of war. But I can't let go. If I do, you'll take a tumble, and the whole thing is gonna crumble. It's a tug of war.
Push it, push it, pull it, pull it, push it, pull it.
I just had to stop right there. The reason why I stopped right there was like, I thought to myself, is this about the Beatles? And then I thought, well, maybe you're just reading things into this. Maybe it's just like coincidental. Maybe it's like a love story or whatever, you know. And then he said something like, you know, I know it's a tug of war, but I had to like, you know, maybe keep on pulling or something, because if I let go, the whole thing will like fall apart. And that's exactly what they said about Paul McCartney and the Beatles. They did say that he was the one who held everything together. He was the one who made sure that, you know, the work ethics, you know, were like maintained. He was the one who like was always like demanding to finish this song, finish that song, get everybody together. So I think this is definitely about the Beatles. And I think it's autobiographical. I really believe so. And it'll be interesting to see if you guys agree with me or not, you know. But a beautiful song. I love the melody. And sadly, right, when I stopped it, a part that I really enjoyed was just coming on, you know. I love what Linda McCartney was doing there with him, you know. That was beautiful, the harmonies. But I'll go back to it now. But I just had to like stop there when I heard him say that it will all fall apart if he let go. I thought to myself, yes, it's the Beatles. Anyway, let's get more.
In years to come, they may discover what the air we breathe. It's a tug of war. What with one thing and another, it's a tug of war.
I think, and when he says, in time to come, we'll be dancing on a different beat, playing on a different drum, I think what he's saying there is like, you know, in future, you know, they will all enjoy each other's work. You know, it's going to be their solo works now, but they will all enjoy it, you know, as opposed to when they were all working together and putting it at each other, like tug of war. So I think it's about not reconciliation, that's a bit of a tough word, but it's just like saying, like, you know, he can see like a brighter, you know, light in future, you know, when they'll all get over all this, right, and they can appreciate each other more. That's what I think he's saying there. Another interesting thing is when I see George Martin, you know, working with Paul McCartney after Beatles, I just think to myself, how ironic is that? Because when they were like working together, Paul McCartney, like, he liked to be in control. He wanted so much control. Now he's a solo artist. He can choose whoever he wants to work with. He can work by himself, you know, but he's gone to George Martin, you know, to take control again. Isn't that crazy? Anyway.
It's a tug of war. What with one thing and another, it's a tug of war. We expected more, but with one thing and another, we were trying to outscore each other in a tug of war.
The strings are so beautiful, and that's a beautiful song, you know. I enjoyed it. I think it's about the Beatles. You know, I think it's a bit obvious, you know. And I just wondered how this went down amongst the others. I don't know if it was before 1980, so I'm not sure if it was before Lennon's death or not, you know. So that'll be interesting, actually, if it was... actually, once again... let's just confirm that. Let's check and see if it was before or after Lennon's death. Okay. It was actually after Lennon's death. It was in 1982. So, I don't know. I don't know how that is now. Maybe he wrote the song before Lennon's death. I don't know. But anyway, all the same, nice song. I liked it. Paul McCartney is my favorite Beatle. So, most of the time, I love everything he does, and I love this one. And I hope you loved it too. And if you did, don't forget to give this video a big like so that YouTube can share it to many more people. And for this, I thank you. For those of you who got here late, you know, just finding me here, welcome on board. I'm glad you're here. I hope you subscribe, stay for a long time, and become a member of the family. Looking forward to that. My name is Harry. Stay cool, stay safe wherever you are. But most of all, stay beautiful in your heart and soul. I'll see you later. Bye.